Hi, this is Gail Sokol. On today's show, we're going to talk about how to make whipped cream.
Welcome to Baking Radio. Learn the art and science of baking with author, educator, and award-winning chef, Gail Sokol. Whether you've been baking your whole life, or you're brand new to the world of baking and you're looking to build your confidence and learn new skills in the kitchen, you're in the right place. This is Baking Radio.
On today's show, we're going to show you how to make whipped cream. And it's super easy to do. You don't even need a recipe, but you have to use the right ingredients and they have to be the right temperature. So first of all, let's talk about cream. You don't want to use half and half, which is half milk and half cream. You want to use heavy cream or what's known as whipping cream. And various brands will have different names. As long as it says whipping cream or heavy cream, you're good. And it has between 36 and 40% milk fat. So that's almost half all fat. It can be referred to as butter fat or milk fat. Got to be very rich because that's what really helps it thicken. This is what whipped cream is usually made from. Now, years ago, when there were more home deliveries by milkmen, and I remember my mom had a milkman that came and we had a little like refrigerated box outside our house, we would get milk in gallon containers. And the fat at the top of the milk, because fat will rise to the surface because it's lighter than water-based ingredients, it actually rises to the top. So if you poured the first couple of tablespoons or whatever from this gallon container was cream. That's what would rise to the surface is the fat from that milk. So the fat of the milk is cream. And this was used to stir into people's coffee or used for whipped cream or what have you. So in order to whip cream successfully, everything needs to be cold. A lot of people, and I won't say crazy people, but people that are really, really serious about their whipped cream, they will put their electric mixing bowl and their whip attachment in the refrigerator. Yep, they will put it in the refrigerator. How many of you have that much room in your refrigerator that you can put your electric mixing bowl and your whip attachment in there? So your heavy cream should be very super cold, not frozen, but cold. And every part, every piece of equipment that you use to touch this heavy cream should be cold. As air is being beaten into the cream, and I'll basically show you how to do this. I'll talk you through how to make heavy cream or whipped cream. As air is beaten into the cream, the droplets of fat become suspended between air bubbles. And the air bubbles are created by your machine, your electric mixer, from the beating process. This thickens the mixture and is what we know and love as whipped cream. And there really is no substitute for real whipped cream other than making it yourself. You can buy store-bought whipped creams that are already made. You can just go, with the machine that they have a little machine in them, a little cartridge in them, and they will propel air through that heavy cream and it's made and you can just sort of put it on your ice cream or pudding or whatever you want. But if you let it sit for about 5 or 10 minutes, guess what happens? It fizzles. It actually goes back to its original form, which is liquid heavy cream. So who needs that? So if you make homemade whipped cream and you beat heavy cream yourself with sugar, you will actually get a more stable product and it should last several hours. Now, you can also get heavy cream, whipped cream, and you can actually get it to stay for a couple of days. I will show you tips and I will show you how to do this. So whipped cream that you purchase, again, fizzles out very, very quickly. Like within a matter of, I'd say 15, 20 minutes, it really does fizzle. But you can extend this time if you put in a little bit of unflavored gelatin to stabilize it. Believe it or not, that actually works. If you take Let's just get a typical recipe to make whipped cream. So take a cup of heavy cream, remember, cold heavy cream, and put it into your cold electric mixer. If you don't put your electric mixing bowl in the refrigerator, it will still beat up. It'll beat a little bit faster if you keep it into the refrigerator, but I usually don't. Don't tell anybody, but I usually don't put it in the refrigerator, my mixing bowl, and it works out fine. But my heavy cream, that's cold. I put my whip attachment on, and I start it on medium-high speed. And then I start adding about a quarter of a cup of confectioner's sugar. This is powdered sugar, not granulated sugar. Some folks like to use granulated sugar. I find that the whipped cream tastes granular, sort of gritty. So confectioner's sugar is the way to go. Confectioner's sugar is finely ground granulated sugar to the point where it's a powder. Sometimes they even put a little starch added to it to prevent it from clumping. But if you add about a quarter of a cup and a teaspoon of vanilla right into that heavy cream and continue beating it until that whipped cream is thick and holds its shape, and the whip attachment, as you remove it, you can actually see it clings to that whip attachment. It doesn't fall off. That's nice and firm. And I love to use it like that because I can not only spoon it on things and smear it all over strawberry shortcakes or put it on top of a pie or a cake. I can also pipe it. I can take my pastry bag and a pastry tip, a big, large rosette pastry tip, and pipe it and make little flowers or rosettes on top of a cake and make it look super, super pretty. So what happens with this heavy cream, you'd put it into a bowl, you'd put it in the refrigerator covered with plastic wrap, and it would last, like I said, several hours. Depends on how much you beat it, how cold your refrigerator is, how much butterfat was in your heavy cream. Depends. There's a lot of depends. In order to have another, more insurance, I love that word, baking insurance, what can you do to stabilize this heavy cream? Well, there's a few things you can do. So I take unflavored gelatin, powdered gelatin, and you take about a teaspoon of that gelatin, mix it with about a tablespoon of water, and you must mix gelatin with a cool liquid. You can even take a little bit of cool heavy cream and add it to the gelatin. That'll work fine too. And you want to blend it, and you want to let it sit and sort of hang out for a little while. The gelatin is very granular, and if you put it in your mouth, it would taste gritty, almost like sand. So you want to bloom it. You want it to soften. So each little granular of gelatin will absorb water or cream that you put it in, and it will soften and get almost like, it almost looks like a jellyfish when you're done with it. You can pour it into a little cup, and then in a few minutes, you can turn that cup upside down, and it won't pour out. It won't come out of the cup because it's completely bloomed or gelled. Once it gets to this stage, you have to melt it down. Now, you could do this in the microwave, but I always like to take a saucepan full of water, maybe an inch of water, heat it up till it's pretty warm but not boiling, and I'll stick my little bowl of my gelatin and water or gelatin and cream into that. Don't let any of that hot water come in contact with the gelatin, but I just want to surround it with warmth so that it melts down and it becomes liquefied. You don't want it to melt, to get hot. If it becomes hot, your whipped cream will fizzle. So once you have this beautiful whipped cream that you've already made, you've added one cup of confectioner's sugar and a teaspoon of pure vanilla extract at the end, you will continue to beat it for just a little while on low speed with this gelatin mixture. Just pour it right in really fast and let it beat in, and that will stabilize your whipped cream. So it will last a day or two. It's fabulous. Another thing that will work is if you take a couple of marshmallows, all right, and you melt them down a little bit, either on the stove or in the microwave, and fold them in or beat them into your heavy cream. That will also stabilize it because marshmallows are made with gelatin. So if you don't have any unflavored gelatin, just throw in some melted marshmallows. That'll work. A little marshmallow fluff would work. You know, you make those fluffernutter sandwiches with those. You just put maybe a tablespoon in, and that would help as well. Another trick that I found, I couldn't believe it just happened. I don't know if anyone else knows about this. You have to write to me on bakingradio.com if you know of this or you've ever heard of this. If you take a little Greek yogurt, plain Greek yogurt or vanilla Greek yogurt, no fruit on the bottom stuff, no fruit in it, and you fold it in with whipped cream, because I have a recipe in my new book, Baking with Success, with a whipped cream frosting on a sponge cake. And if you fold in some Greek yogurt, guess what happens? That whipped cream, that lasts almost a week. Are you listening? It's almost 7 days. And it doesn't weep. It doesn't start going back to its original liquid state. I thought that was unbelievable. If anyone's ever heard of that, you just have to go to bakingradio.com and just throw me a line and tell me that happened to you and you discovered that too. So let me tell you a story about what happens when you overbeat heavy cream. Okay. You need a laugh? This is a laugh. So I was in my first job as a pastry chef. Matter of fact, this restaurant was so nice. They created the job of pastry chef just for me because they never had a pastry chef before. So they said, you know, why don't you go make like 4 quarts of whipped cream? And they have big mixers. I mean, big mixers there. So this was a big tabletop mixer made by a brand that's usually, they make all the huge mixers. People refer to it as, oh, go mix this in the Hobart. And that I put 4 quarts because we used to buy heavy cream there in quart sizes. Never know the little cup sizes, but a big quart. I poured 4 of them into this bowl, this electric mixing bowl. And I took the whip attachment, which was bigger than my head. You know, it looks like a giant whisk, but it's huge. And I put it on there. And I figured, okay, it's going to take several minutes to beat this cream because there's a lot of heavy cream there. I put my sugar in after it started getting a little thicker. And I walked away for a minute to get a few other ingredients. And when I came back, I heard sloshing and lump, 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 like going around in a circle being beaten, like something got in there, something fell in there that was solid. And I thought, oh my God, what did I do? So I stopped the machine. I was really like very embarrassed and sheepishly looked in the bowl and there was this big fat clump, like this ball of yellowish material and watery based liquid around it. I didn't know what happened. So one of the other chefs came by and looked in the bowl and said, oh, was that your heavy cream? And I said, yeah. I said, what did I just do? He said, you just made butter. So if you overbeat heavy cream, something interesting happens. You make butter. So that thick clump that I made, that was butter. And the liquid around it, that was the whey, W-H-E-Y, that was the whey or the liquid from that butter. And that's what happens when you create butter. And years ago, that liquid was actually used as buttermilk. And that's how people that were, you know, home chefs and housewives, that's how they made butter. They churned their cream. And what was left after the butter formed was this liquid. And this liquid whey was the buttermilk. And it was acidic. So they could use it in quick breads to make like buttermilk pancakes and all sorts of wonderful quick breads like that. So I learned my lesson. I never knew how to make butter. So my next job as a pastry chef, I was being interviewed by the executive chef and he said, you know, sometimes I like to make my own compound butter, which is butter that has had herbs mixed in or flavorings mixed in, lemon zest, other flavorings mixed in. Then you can actually put You refrigerate it and you can actually put it on top of a fish or a steak after it's cooked and you let it melt over it instead of a fancy sauce. It's called the compound butter. And he said, do you know how to make butter? And I said, yes, I do. And I was laughing to myself because I only knew how to make butter by accident. I was so crazy. I did not know what I was doing when that happened. But you know what? It was wonderful because now I know how to make butter. So Today we learned how to make fabulous whipped cream and butter if you want to make it. We also learned how to stabilize that whipped cream so it lasts a lot longer and you get more use of it. And you don't have to just make it while your guests are enjoying dinner in the other room and you're just, you know, crazily beating the stuff to death. You can actually enjoy your dessert with your friends and family. So if you have any questions and you want to head on over to bakingradio.com and leave me a message, I would love that. I would love to answer some of your questions on air. Next week's show, we're going to be discussing fermentation.